It is with a very warm heart that I welcome you to today's episode of Tax Matters, your home for information, education, and enlightenment on taxation. If you want information, if you want knowledge, if you want enlightenment on how to go about fulfilling your civic duties as a taxpayer, this is the place to be. Week after week, Tax Matters comes to you with fresh information on your rights, your duties, and your responsibilities. So how is business going? That oil prices have been on a free fall in the last few months is no longer a secret. And with that free fall in the price of oil on the international market has come a fall, a drastic fall, in the revenue accruing to our dear country, Nigeria. GDP growth rate has also been on the downward slide. The last two quarters of 2015 has seen a dip in GDP growth rate as against the 7% of 2014 and the 10% target set by the Muhammadu Buhari administration. So the question on everybody's lips is, what is the way out? How does Nigeria come out of the woods and become vibrant once again? To share thoughts on the efforts being made by the Federal Revenue Service in that regard, that is, with regard to shoring up revenue accruing to Nigeria from non-oil sources, is a deputy director and head of light tax audit of the FRS in Abuja in the person of Mr. Ikechukwu Onu. Before coming on to this beat, Mr. Onu was a debt collector of sorts. He was the head of the debt management office, the DMO of the FRS, and he did quite a good job on that beat. From there, he moved on to serve as the regional coordinator, Lagos Mainland East Region of the Federal Revenue Service in Lagos. Mr. Onu, you're welcome to Tax Matters.
Thank you for having me.
You had an introduction, what you know very well. We can't even know this better than you, that revenue from oil sources, from oil taxes, are dipping. What is the current mix of the collections by the FRS, the tax collections by the FRS, from oil taxes and non-oil taxes? What is the mix?
Yes, thank you. The FRS has, over the years, has been placing emphasis on ensuring that the non-oil taxes far outweighs that from the oil taxes for obvious reasons, you know, because it's for sustainability and for revenue generation and to get the benefit of taxation as instrument of both fiscal policy, industrial, you know, development and social engineering. Mm-hmm. We need to actually pay emphasis on non-oil taxes. Okay. Last year, 2014, FRS achieved 48% to 52% non-oil taxes to oil taxes.
48 for oil, 52 for non-oil?
Yes, for 2014. As at September this year, 2015, we have improved to 67% of non-oil taxes to 33% of the oil taxes.
That's very commendable.
And actually the target for the year is 60% for non-oil and 40 for the oil.
Is that because the price of oil is falling or you are doing better?
It's partly, yes. The price of oil has fallen and so the taxes falling from oil, of course, has come down. Mm. So it's part of it, partly.
Okay, but you are doing well all the same.
Well, I wouldn't say we're doing well because we can do better, you know, because government needs revenue to carry out their programs. So we need to actually support them by performing far above our target. Mm. But I think we're on track.
But let's go a bit fundamental. What would you, at the FRS, on the global tax level, which taxes constitute non-oil taxes?
Well, basically, every tax, you know, imposed on incomes, profits, transactions, or even assets of individuals, corporate bodies, on income that does not accrue from oil and gas businesses in Nigeria. These are the non-oil taxes. Okay. So you can talk about company income tax, You can talk about personal income taxes, value-added taxes, capital gains taxes, even property taxes. And if you want to extend it to revenue generally, you can even talk about customs duties. You know, that's for import and export, that's for revenue, they're not taxes per se. Yes.
Now, let's look at company's income tax, because that seems to be the biggest for you, for the FRS. Personal income tax is basically collected by the states, although you collect for officers of Foreign Affairs Ministry, officers and men of the armed forces and the police force. We'll come to that. But we look at company's income tax. Who are those that are charged to tax under CIT, under CITA?
Well, as the name implies, every corporate body, incorporated, every corporate body is liable to pay company income tax. So whether the limited liability companies or public limited liability companies, you know, they're liable to pay income tax. Even incorporated NGOs, not per se, but if they have income from other sources that is not in their main mandate, they ought to pay taxes on those incomes.
Okay. The FRS collects?
Yeah, that's purely by
the country, wherever I am in the country.
Corporate taxes.
Where does that money go into?
Well, it goes to the federation accounts. You know, that's where it should go to.
It's everybody?
Yes, everybody. No, everybody benefits from it. The monthly FARC meetings where states, you know, come over to Abuja. Mm. Yeah, it's part of what they share.
Let's move on to VAT, value-added tax. Who collects that one?
Yes, well, all taxes, apart from the personal income tax, which states collect and FRS collect to some extent also, as you have said earlier on, is collected by the Foreign Land Revenue Service. Okay. So not only for VAT, even capital gains tax, as I mentioned before, is also FRS. So all those taxes, you know, are collected
who
by
pays
FRS.
VAT?
Everybody pays VAT. Of course, it's based on consumption. So as long as you consume items that are amenable to VAT charges, of course you are paying. You know, that's why, you know, it's that way. Everybody pays VAT.
And when the FRS collects, what does it do with it? Does it keep it? Does it give it to President Buhari?
No, of course it goes to also an account, the VAT account, okay, where, you know, in fact the main beneficiaries are the states and local governments. So where it's also, you know, shared in proportion to the way the law has stipulated it to be.
Okay, okay, okay. So what measures have you put in place at the FRS to ensure that you really help government to achieve this aim of bringing Nigeria out of the woods? You've spoken about how this year you have moved to a ratio of 33 for oil taxes, 67 for non-oil. What has been the secret of that improvement?
Well, you know, in tax administration, there are basically, you know, sequence. Talk about registration of taxpayers, where you come and register. So to that extent, we try to, you know, make it easier for you to register. You hardly will spend more than 15 minutes at most to get your tax identification number in any of our tax offices.
Sorry?
Yes. So TIN generation can be done in any FRS office. So, and it's a very minimal requirements. You get it. They talk about the filing of...
Is it free?
Of course, it's free.
I don't have to pay money.
No, no. So
what if I registered my company with the Corporate Affairs Commission maybe last year, and I just want to hit the call now, and I approach the tax office to get a taxpayer identification number? Are we not going to be looking at what I should have paid if I had come earlier?
No, well, the law gives you a 6 months window within which a new company authorizes. But you see, there's so much ignorance in the system. So what we do is that when you come, of course you register, nobody will ask you about those taxes until you now, you know, start filing your returns, okay, or begin to make demands for tax clearance. But registration, nobody will ask you whether you registered 10 years ago. Just go and register. It's your right, and that is it.
And it is free.
It is free.
Okay. Okay, so registration.
Yeah, so registration, so we make it easy. Then next aspect is assessment. And now for the past 3 years, we've been emphasis on self-assessment. So where taxpayer completes his account and files whatever he or she feels, you know, he should pay. Mm-hmm. So make it easier. Then the next part is the payment. Now we have different payment channels. You know, payment can be done through e-payment, it can go to the bank, and we're establishing more and more channels through which it can be easier for a taxpayer to stay in his house and make payments. Then of course, our own part, about taxpayer service. We will try to, you know, educate taxpayers, enlighten them, and also, you know, invest in a modern taxpayer service processes. So we have them all over. In fact, now there's a division of taxpayer services in the, you know, regional offices, just to strengthen that service. Of course, we talk about compliance and enforcement. The audit is one of them. We are strengthening our audit function. That's why you can find very senior officers, deputy directors, being head of audits, you know, and also, you know, we also have the enforcement. We have the debt enforcement at the regional offices. Mm-hmm. So we start with compliance, teach you, notify you, advise you. But if you are recalcitrant, then of course the law has to take its course. So these are all areas that we are trying to, you know, enhance the tax that comes, you know, from non-oil taxes. And you see our new chairman, our acting chairman, just coming also with some vision, whereby he thinks that VAT should be much more than, you know, we are collecting now. Currently, there's a VAT and withholding tax sensitization going on all over the Federation. So the attempt is to make people understand. And also there's a program on TV, on radio, on VAT sensitization. All is geared towards expanding tax base that people, you know, begin to, you know, comply with the tax laws. Of course, there's also the restructuring generally that's going on in the system. You know, we're always trying to keep abreast with the needs, you know, of the season. You know, so these are, you know, many ways that we are working to ensure that we prop up the tax revenue, particularly from the non-oil sector.
Okay, you spoke about self-assessment. We'll come to that presently. But talking about registration and then moving on to filing, of which self-assessment is a major part. At the beginning of the year, there was some talk about the number of companies in the database of the Corporate Affairs Commission as against the number that are filing tax returns. Would you say that you are making progress with regard to getting more people to fulfill their obligations right now?
Well, you see, Nigeria is a peculiar place where even people who are working elsewhere might go to incorporate companies with the hope of doing business in the future. And they put them in their briefcases and they never do anything with them for 5-10 years. So that's one. So you begin to have what you call dormant cases, you know. So, you know, you don't expect them to bring to a file, even though the law says that, but they just put it there. Then also you have the NCR, the newly commenced businesses. They have a window of almost 18 months, you know, begin to file. So, you know, that also is part of it. Then also you have those who are registered with us, who are in the system, but who refuse to do the right thing. So these are all what affects that statistics that say that many of them are not in the tax net, you know. So, but you need to do some analysis to find those dormant ones, the ones that have been filing before, that they stopped filing. Maybe they have gone out of business, but because they don't close up their businesses as they should, they just leave it and go. But there's a law on how to, you know, close up your business. Yes. Decision rules, you know. Even CAMA, Corporate, you know, Company and Allied Matters Act, have provisions how, you know, you properly,
you just leave it
exactly, and inform the system service. But they leave it there, and to us, they are in business, but in actual fact, they are not in business. So we need to really do proper analysis before we begin to say, okay, what's the compliance level? But generally speaking, the tax gap is quite enormous in the system. Nobody can deny that. You know, there's apathy, you know, there's so much excuses for not doing the right things, you know. So we know that. We are working. We are working to let people understand that it's their civic obligation. And it's like a chicken and egg. If you don't do it, government wouldn't have enough money to do their services for you, and you complain against the government. So we need to really, you know, support one another.
This is the era of change in Nigeria. Phenomenal change that will greatly impact positively on different sectors of our national life. If any meaningful change will happen in our nation, government needs your support. Start by paying your tax. Corporations and multinationals, pay your company income tax, value-added tax, national IT development tax, and education tax, among others. You know the immense benefits of paying your tax on time. You know the consequences of not doing so. Avoid the consequences. Enjoy the benefits. It's a new dawn in Nigeria. The Federal Inland Revenue Service says it pays to pay your tax.
I know this is not under your purview, but from what you just spoke about, people register companies and just put the certificates in their briefcase or under their pillow. Doesn't the Corporate Affairs Commission have a way of delisting those companies instead of them remaining in the books?
Actually, every year, every company is supposed to file annual returns with the Corporate Affairs Commission.
That's true.
To show that they are in existence. Yeah. You know, but how many of them do that? That's another question. So they tried, and you know, I think until they begin to liaise with the banks, that's where the success will come. But then it's a lot of control function that I don't know whether they're set up for it now. Mm. But I think it's a systemic thing. It's a Nigerian thing. And you don't incorporate the company unless you have a business to do. So why go to, you know, or you're hoping that your friend becomes a minister tomorrow, or DG, and you go and incorporate the company, hoping. And when it doesn't happen, you abandon the company, nobody understands, So, but I think with time, people are getting more enlightened, people are getting more, you know, enlightened about taxes and all these things. So when we begin to enforce more and more, then people will realize that, look, it's not more a tea party.
The CAC should enforce, should insist on the annual filing,
yes,
so that we know those who are in business and those who are not in business. Yes. But still on that matter, what are the implications for me of registering and keeping that certificate? If I now wake up 5 years after, or 5 years after, like you say, it's a Nigerian thing, I now suddenly feel that something will come from a ministry or an MDA or a local government. To you as a taxman, how are you going to treat me?
Well, tax is based on laws.
Yes.
So no taxman works with his own initiative, so to say, or discretion. It must be based on law. The law says if you don't register within 6 months, then and you don't file your returns every year, there's any penalty, both for non-registration and for non-filing.
Okay.
So a taxman will do his job based on law.
Okay.
But what we keep on telling taxpayers, if you recuperate the company and you're not yet commenced business, let the tax office know.
How do I do that?
Write to the tax office. Or even the form in which you fill to register, you said, I've not commenced. Commencement, no, not yet commenced. But the only thing you can do is that maybe every year you file a statement of affairs, which is just basically, you know, nothing happening there. So at least we know that you've not commenced business.
Okay.
So, you know, but if you don't do that, of course, you know, the taxman must do his job. And then once you start the date of registration and when you say you've commenced business, then, you know, you apply the laws, the penalties and all those things that follows non-compliance.
And you also spoke about if I've stopped doing business, that there are processes to follow,
yes,
in letting the tax authorities know that I've stopped doing business. Cessation, right?
Yeah, you fire, you let us know. Of course, we have an option on the way we tax you. You know, because when you commence business, you have a choice. You can elect that you tax, you know, then we too have a choice when you are leaving. So let us know. You prepare your account, close up the business, we will do our work, and you quietly, you know, let the business go. So nobody bothers any longer. But if you don't say it, then, of course, you'll be incurring liabilities.
We said we will return to self-assessment. Talking about self-assessment, are taxpayers cooperating now? Well, what is the level of compliance?
You know, in FRS, we have segments, taxpayer segments. When you talk about the micro and the small taxpayers, of course, the compliance level is not that much for obvious reasons. One, most of them may not be able to afford service of a chartered accountant to prepare their accounts. Most of them don't even keep proper records. So most of them can't even afford tax professionals to put in their papers for them. So, and they don't just understand, they don't know. So for that level of taxpayers, we have issues with them for sure. The compliance level is quite low. Now coming up to the medium tax and large taxpayers, of course, these are more bigger businesses that can afford to employ people. So we have more compliance, you know, at that level. So, you know, it's a mixed bag. So that's why we are targeting our taxpayer services, especially to the micro and small taxpayers who are more in number. In fact, those numbers you mentioned are CAC, most of them are in that category. You know, one-man businesses, basically. So that's why we have issues with their compliance. But generally, the large taxpayers and the medium taxpayers, the compliance level is quite high.
Okay. You are presently in charge of light tax audits in Abuja here. When taxpayers hear audits, they shake. Eh? What do you do?
Yeah, that's why the restructuring that took place April, May, said that we upgrade the level of officers that will head the audit. You know, currently it's deputy directors. So we try to let people know that, look, we are not enforcement officers. We are compliance officers. So, yes, there are two different things.
Compliance
is helping the taxpayer to do voluntarily
that
which the law says you do. Enforcement is compulsion. And I can't enforce you unless I've made it to comply. So that's why, you see, we notify you, can we come for a deed? We need these records. We want to come at such a date. You can say, okay, sorry.
You don't just badge in on me.
No, you can say, no, that day is not good for me. Can you give me? Most time we're obliged. So we do that. And that make you know that, look, because we are auditing you, that means that you are complying already. Because if you don't file your returns, I can audit you. Because I'm auditing you based on what you have filed. So the fact that you are auditing you means that you are a compliant taxpayer. So I'm not treated with respect, with dignity. Yes.
So that's what you are making me happier.
That's what it should be. We're not, we are friends. And we made some mistakes in the past. We can establish some additional assessment, fine. But we'll not jail you for the assessment. You only penalize you and maybe penalty and interest and advise you on going forward. But the enforcement will, compel you to do the right thing. So that are two different things. So people should not be afraid of auditors. We are compliance officers.
So we should not be afraid of auditors.
No.
I should not be afraid of you.
No, you shouldn't be. You're my friend.
I like that. So what is the goal of the service on this matter, this cocoa matter of non-oil taxes vis-a-vis oil taxes?
This year, the target is 60-40 for non-oil. Of course, if you check where we're coming from before, it was almost the reverse. But now we are working towards that. And I can see we have a new chairman. He has his own vision. You can see he's a compliance and enforcement kind of person that wants people to comply with tax laws.
So your final word, can taxation come to the rescue of Nigeria?
Of course. That is what Nigeria needs to be rescued from. Taxation is the only way. Because look at the benefits of taxation. Talk about income redistribution, where the rich pays more tax than the poor. It helps to build social equilibrium. where you give some tax holidays or incentives to industries to locate in the hinterland. That's also so. Tax is, you know, it's the only way that you can have a sustainable source of income to manage and to finance the economy. So we need to really pay emphasis on our tax system and on the processes under administration for this country to have a stable development. Not the oil that comes boom today, tomorrow is doomed. No, that is the only way that you can actually have a sustainable growth.
We want to thank you most sincerely for coming on to the program. We wish the Federal Inland Revenue Service the best of luck in its endeavors, in its efforts in making sure that we raise enough revenue from taxes. Because in doing that, everybody will benefit. Thank you for coming on to the program.
Thanks for having me. You're welcome.